Good morning, children. In the last class, I had told you regarding Salarino's views about the sadness of Antonio. Pay attention to the slide on the screen. Today we will see what Salarino has to say regarding Antonio's sadness. He says, "Believe me, sir." Believe me means trust me, Antonio. Had I such venture forth, if I ran such a business in abroad nations, venture is business, and forth means abroad nations, the best part of my affections, then most of my thoughts would be with my hopes abroad. With my hopes means with my ships abroad. He means to say that if his ships would have been at sea, he would always be thinking about them. I should be still. I should be still means I should be always plucking the grass to know where sits the wind. He would be always checking the direction of the wind by seeing, or rather holding up a blade of grass. He would be looking, peering means looking. He would be looking in maps to find out ports, harbors and channels. Roads are channels through which his ships would pass, or where they could take rest. And every object means anything, and anything that might make me fear, and anything that might pose a risk, cause a risk. Risk of what? Misfortune to my ventures. Cause a risk of bad luck. Misfortune means bad luck. To my ventures means to his ships. Out of doubt. Out of doubt means undoubtedly. Out of doubt means undoubtedly. He means to say that any object which would be the cause of risk or bad luck for his ship would make him sad. Children, indirectly, Salarino wants to say that Antonio is sad thinking about his ships which are on the sea. Moving on to Salarino's speech. Salarino continues to give his reasons for Antonio's sickness. He first takes the example of his soup being cooled by his breath. See the first line of Salarino's speech, children. My wind cooling my broth. It means if Salarino was to cool his soup, broth is soup, with the help of his breath, it would blow me. Blow me means it would drive him to an ague. Ague means a feverish fit. Ague is a feverish fit. Why he would be drawn to a feverish fit? Because his breath, which would make the soup shiver, would remind him of the damage. Harm means damage. The high winds. A wind too great means the high winds which would blow at the sea would do to his ship. The breath is compared to the great winds blowing at the sea and the damage that they could cause to his ships. Then in the second description, he says, I should not see. I should not see means whenever I saw. Pay attention, children. I should not see means Whenever I saw, what did he see? Whenever he saw the hourglass. Hourglass was an instrument to measure time during the Elizabethan period. So, whenever he saw the hourglass, but I should think mean I would be reminded of. What would I be reminded of? Shallows. Shallows means shallow water. Flats means the sandbanks in the sea. And sea means I would visualize. I would imagine my wealthy Andrew, my wealthy ship, docked in sand. Docked in sand means buried in the sand. Docked in sand means buried in the sand. Veiling her high top means lowering her mast lower than her ribs. Ribs are side of the ship. Means the mast of the ship would be buried into the sand. She would be buried. Should I go to the church? And Salarino says that in case he went to the church, and when he saw the holy edifice of stone, children, edifice is building. When he would see the holy building of the church, which was made of stone, and not bethink me, I would be immediately reminded of. I repeat, and not bethink me means I would be immediately reminded of the dangerous rocks which are present in the ocean and which, on touching my ship's side, would scatter, would distribute all her spices, all the spices which are carried by the ship on the stream. On the stream means on the sea. Enrobe the roaring waters with my silks, and the silk which my ship was carrying. I explain again, children, that if the dangerous rocks would touch the ship, that means if the ship was hit by these rocks, then the spices which were in the ship and even the silk which the ship was carrying would all be scattered on the ocean. And in a word means the gist of everything is, but even now worth this and now worth nothing. The line means put a bracket from but even now till nothing and write on the top that the ship which a moment ago was very worthy, after a moment it becomes useless. Just after a moment it becomes useless when it hits the dangerous rocks. Then Salarino says, shall I have the thought to think all this, that I can think all this if my ship is on the sea? And shall I lack the thought that such a thing bechanced would make me sad? And then how can I accept the fact of thinking, that how cannot I accept the fact of thinking that if such a thing happened to my ship, it would not make me sad? Indirectly, he wants to tell Antonio that when the ships are at sea, always some negative thoughts will come into our mind, and Antonio should be ready to accept that these thoughts are the cause of his sadness. So he again addresses Antonio and says, please do not tell me, Antonio, that because I already know that you are sad to think upon your merchandise. You are sad because you are thinking about the misfortunes that can befall on your cargo. Antonio is yet not satisfied by the reasons which are given by his friends. He tells them, "Believe me, no, this is not the cause." Why? Why the ships are not the cause? Because he thanks his luck, his fortune for it. Why? There are three reasons for that, children. Three reasons for why Antonio is not sorrowful because of his ships. Number one, please mark. My ventures are not in one bottom trusted. This means that Antonio's business is not tied to one ship alone. Is not tied means is not limited. Is not tied means is not limited to one ship alone. Second point, nor to one place. Not to one place means his ships have not gone to one place. They are in different directions. And third point, children, nor is not my whole estate upon the fortune of this present year. It means that his finances, whole estate means Antonio's finances, does not depend on the profit of the present year. These three reasons are very important, that his ships, or rather his merchandise, is not present in one ship. His ships have not gone to a single place, nor does his profit of the year, nor does his finances depend on the present year's profit. Therefore, my merchandise, my ships do not make me sad. This is what Antonio wants to say. Then Salarino